Well, shit. Hey guys, obviously you probably know by now, Rocket Lab's mission last night suffered a failure. The satellite did not reach its intended orbit, so bad news for Rocket Lab, bad news for Capella Space. And just yesterday, I came out with a video talking about how pleased I am with the progress of the Electron rocket and how well it's doing, all their new contracts, all that kind of stuff. And of course, a few hours later, we have this failure. So I think it's pretty clear here that this is my fault for jinxing them. Sorry so much to all you investors out there. You can blame me for this one. But seriously, I just wanted to share with you basically what happened, my thoughts on what happened, the implications for the stock, and also a trade of mine that just got triggered this morning. Let's go through all of that in 1 minute, but first, if you haven't already, I hope you'll consider hitting subscribe. By the end of the video, every subscriber is very much appreciated. Thank you guys so much. With that out of the way, let's take a look at Rocket Lab stock and the Electron failure. First off, I figured I'd just share the quick video of what happened during the launch coverage. It's a little bit spotty at times, but still worth a watch.
Nico confirmed.
So there we have stage separation, and keep an eye on the speed as well as we attempt to light here. We do get video freezing, and that is pretty much it for the quick short clip of what went wrong. Clearly the second stage tried to ignite. We did have a successful stage separation, but we weren't getting any more speed there, and for whatever reason it looks like the second stage was not able to successfully ignite. So I'm sure we're going to get more details on that as Rocket Lab completes their investigation, but let's continue on with some more info about the implications of this for the stock. So definitely a wild ride in the pre-market here. You can see the fall off a cliff after the stock began trading in the morning. And basically, it actually has kind of turned out better than I expected. We're kind of rising off the lows throughout the day. And we did actually have a lot lower than this in the pre-market. We're seeing a low when it opened of around 4.37 per share. But I saw trades in the pre-market of people picking up shares all the way down at like 360. So yes, pre-market is extremely volatile. Sometimes it can work out in your favor. Sometimes it can work against you. I've never traded in pre-market or after hours before. But yeah, some people were able to pick up shares extremely cheap. And, you know, hopefully it works out for them. We are seeing at least today they've done very well as the stock does continue to make a little bit of a comeback. Just Peter Beck talking about the failure on Twitter, saying, "Tough day, deepest apologies to our mission partners, Capella Space. Team is already working on root cause. We'll find it, fix it, and be back on the pad quickly." So, clearly bad for Capella Space, but they will have insurance like that will cover the cost of the satellite. Still not a good situation because, you know, they'd much rather have their satellite orbiting and functioning properly than the cost that they're going to get back from insurance. So not a disaster for Capella, but, you know, not good either, and it could potentially cause insurance for future launches on Electron to go up, something we'll also need to keep in mind. Few other details here on a Michael Sheets article quickly published to CNBC about the failure. So Rocket Lab said it's begun working with the FAA on investigating the root cause of the issue already, which appeared to happen around the time the rocket's first and second stages separated. I would say just after that stage separation. And of course, the shares did fall as much as 26% in the pre-market, massive drop. Over a quarter of the value of the stock, hundreds of millions of dollars off the valuation of the company for a launch that, you know, would bring in $7.5 million in revenue. So definitely massive drop in the valuation relative to the drop in revenue resulting from the single launch. Of course, there is a bit more to the story and the bigger picture. We're going to talk about that in a minute. So the company's 42nd Electron mission was also set to launch before the end of the third quarter, but Rocket Lab warned it will be postponed while it resolves the launch failure. As a result, Rocket Lab expects to issue revised third quarter guidance. So we'll be looking out for that for those revised guidance numbers in the coming days, but it shouldn't be too hard to guess. We're not going to have that extra launch, and then this launch was a failure. So pretty easy math to do, and definitely, you know, not good for the quarter for Rocket Lab. And then in terms of how long they may be grounded for until they can get back in the air, a rocket can remain grounded for an uncertain amount of time, with the length of investigations depending upon the severity of the issue. After the previous failure with Electron, Rocket Lab was grounded for 70 days. So I believe the rules around this are Rocket Lab is not allowed to launch any other Electrons until they've figured out the root cause of this failure and explained to the FAA how they're going to fix it and make sure it would not happen again. So they can't just fire off another rocket, writing this off as an anomaly without understanding the root cause and making sure it's been mitigated, something that will clearly take some time. So that's pretty much all the information we have right now from Rocket Lab, CNBC, and the FAA. And just some initial thoughts on this. So yes, obviously, I'm really not happy about it. I was feeling very confident about Electron launches, their reliability. They haven't failed in a couple years. Definitely wasn't seeing this coming. Didn't have this in any of my financial models. So things are really going to change. The failure that we had with Electron last time was also around the second stage. So, you know, maybe that 70-day number is a good guideline to look at for when they'll be able to get up and running in the fourth quarter. And if that is the case, it will be very bad for fourth quarter numbers as well. They'll basically only have December to try and cram in as many launches as they can, 70 days taking you to almost the end of November. So I'm sure they would do their best to cram in launches left, right, and center, assuming customers would be available because their launches would have been scheduled to have already happened by that point. Maybe they can cram in, you know, between their two launch complexes and the two pads in New Zealand. Four launches, is that reasonable? One per week? I don't know. We'll have to see how quickly they can get those off and what their capacity is in December. But it'll be bad for the third quarter. It'll be probably worse for the fourth quarter unless they can really cram in those launches. And it's obviously going to hit their overall numbers for the year because, you know, they still have to spend money on their launch pads, on all their infrastructure. They're still paying all the same staff. So this is really going to cause further losses and deepened losses over the next few quarters until they get flying again. Having said that, I would say the bright side is that this is really deferring the revenue, not losing the revenue for the rest of the upcoming launches. So everything on their manifest that may not happen, you know, next quarter, may not happen this year, is still going to happen next year. And hopefully, you know, with the problems they've had with customer readiness before, they do have the capacity to get all those payloads off next year. So maybe, you know, next year will look even better in terms of cadence because they'll have all these extra launches pushed. But no doubt that they're going to end up burning more cash this year than me, or I assume you, or anyone really wanted them to burn. And a lot of the time when we have one of these big moves in the stock, like with when Peter sold, my thought process is, okay, well, nothing's really changed with the underlying company. This is just stock moving in the short term. As long as the company's executing well and things are going well, I'm happy. But in this scenario, something did happen with the underlying company. They were not able to execute well on this launch, unfortunately, and, you know, numbers will be impacted. So yes, I still do have confidence in the Rocket Lab team. I do think they'll sort this out. It is pretty common in the launch industry for this kind of thing to happen. Electron has been a very reliable vehicle. But yeah, the short-term effect is not good, and I do think it's more likely now than it was yesterday that they are going to have to potentially raise capital at some point before going profitable. So that's something else to think about. But at least the stock price is rebounding nicely off of those lows. That's one small silver lining. And I did just want to share with you one trade I actually made this morning. And funny enough, I made this trade without even realizing I'd made it. So this is actually the trade I made today around Rocket Lab. I basically had an order sitting out there waiting for several days. I didn't think it would ever get triggered. Rocket Lab would have had to drop pretty low for someone to want to take the other side of this trade. But wouldn't you know it, with this failure that happened, someone decided they do want to take the other side, and it did trigger. So what happened is basically, if on October 13th, Rocket Lab is below $4 per share, I will need to buy it for $4 per share. And for this right, the person on the other side who would be selling me those shares for $4 per share is paying me 15 cents per share. So basically, you can think of it as I've agreed to buy 1,000 shares of Rocket Lab for $3.85 per share if it's at that level or lower on October 13th, something I find extremely unlikely. Obviously, I would need around $4,000 to buy all those shares if that does happen. And yeah, I thought this was extremely unlikely to get triggered. I just figured I'd leave it out there in case someone, for whatever reason, did buy it from me, which they did. I received $150 up front minus commissions, which brings me down to $143. And yeah, I feel very good about this trade. It's already moved up significantly because the stock has rebounded. So I'm already basically 50% up. If I did want to buy it back and close out right now, I would only have to pay about $70. So, you know, I'm already up $75-ish. But I'm not going to close out of the position. I am going to leave it to expiry. If it does, for some reason, drop below $4, I'll be very happy to pick up more shares at $3.85 cost basis. Really hard to beat that. In terms of what else I would be thinking of doing, I was kind of interested in adding shares. I was thinking about it, but the stock has recovered pretty quickly though, and I will consider adding more shares, I think, if I don't significantly increase my cost basis. My cost basis right now is around 4.5, so I would ideally like to keep it lower than that if I do add new shares, something I'll still consider in the next few weeks as we see how the stock price develops. So just to wrap up, I am disappointed. I definitely didn't expect this to happen. I do think this will impact the underlying numbers of the business. So it does matter to me. It's not just when there's, you know, price fluctuations in the stock price. We will see more cash burn for the year than I was projecting and than I was thinking. And we'll have to wait till we get more details to fully understand the implications for the rest of the year, depending on when they get flying again, how serious the issue is. So I'm pretty bummed by this. I'm not going to lie. I do think this trade I've made, although it's only, you know, $150, I think it's going to work out for me, and I'll probably just end up with the full $150. If I don't, I'll be very happy to buy $4,000 worth of Rocket Lab shares at $3.85 per share. Let me know how you guys are feeling about the company. Are you still confident? Are you adding more shares during the dip? Always interested to continue the discussion in the comments below. I do think the company will be able to recover from this in the long run. They will figure out what went wrong. They're very competent. They will eventually get those launches off that are on the manifest. They'll probably get pushed to next year. Maybe this will make next year look even better, and we'll have a big, you know, run up next year. That'll remain to be seen. Interested to hear your thoughts on all these topics and more down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you'll consider subscribing if you haven't already. I hope you have a great day and you're not taking the bad news too hard. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.